Hi everyone, my name is Leah Kopke and I'm a 3D motion design freelancer. I also have a podcast where each week I cover another 3D modeling tool for Cinema 4D. Hello and welcome. Today we're going to go over the pinch brush for sculpting inside of Cinema 4D. So let's go ahead and get started. So here we are inside of Cinema 4D. I'm going to go ahead and drop a plane into the scene to start off with. I'm going to increase the segments all the way to 100, and then I'll hit the C hotkey in order to make this editable. You can also hit this button down here to make it editable. If your screen doesn't quite look like mine, you can change from standard mode, which is the default. You can see the different modes listed up here. Standard mode, your standard layout, to your sculpting layout over here just by clicking that button. Once you click the sculpting layout, you have all of your brushes shown to the left, which is nice and handy because that's what we use for sculpting. You can also find your brushes under the mesh menu in either one of these modes, the standard or the sculpting. So if you go under sculpt under the mesh menu, you can see a lot of these are here, or the brushes are listed over here. So this is where you'll find your sculpting tools, pretty simple. And so let's talk about what we're going over today. We're going over the pinch tool. So you can see it's listed down here, pinch. So what does it do? It pulls the vertices together to create a crease or to pinch it together in a sense. It does a lot like what it sounds like it does. So think of working with clay. When you pinch the clay together, that's basically what you're doing here. So let's go ahead and make sure we have our plane selected. If we were to use this tool on the surface, you can begin to see that it is pulling the vertices together as so. So you can use this in conjunction with other tools. That's where it comes in really helpful. For instance, if you were to use the draw brush, and we've covered the draw brush, I'll leave that to the in the links below. But if I were to draw something with the draw brush, and then let's say I want to make a really nice crease, like maybe we're 3D modeling a pillow or something like that, and we want it to have really nice details, or if we're 3D modeling a bag of chips and we really want some nice creases on that bag of chips or on that pillow we're 3D modeling, you can go ahead and use your handy pinch tool over here to bring those vertices together and make a really nice crease after using the brush tool. And you can actually use this tool in conjunction with other ones. So if you go over to your modifiers tab within the pinch settings, so right over here when you have the pinch brush selected and you enable modifiers, you'll see that you can actually use this brush at the same time as using another brush. So if you want to use the pinch brush and the draw brush at the same time, instead of using one after the other, you can turn on the draw brush and then you can select the strength, which controls how much strength the draw brush has in conjunction with the pinch brush. And then when you draw, you're going to be using them together. So you can use a combination of the tools. You can do the same thing with smooth by checking this on, and you can adjust the strength of the smooth. You can also do this with inflate, and we are going to cover the inflate in the future. So that's one really useful thing to know about this tool. I have another video where I go through all the stamp settings because those are the same for all the brushes. I have another video where I go through all of the settings within the settings tab because those are very similar for most of the brushes. And the same is true for the basic tab. So I'll leave links to those videos below. I just want to cover what was unique to this tool so that you can work with it and feel like you're an expert as you're working. If you have any questions though, please feel welcome to leave them in the comments below. If you'd like to learn more 3D modeling tools inside of Cinema 4D, please hit like and subscribe so that you'll be notified when the next episode comes out. And thank you so much for taking the time to 3D model with me here on Ambient 3D Animations. I hope to see you here again next week, and happy 3D modeling!